All right, folks, back again. He is the voice of the Southern All-Star Super Late Models, Dwayne Keith.
All right, Travis Pennington, Austin Horton, Nate Jumpton. Oh, they're going to wave this start off. Very auspicious start. So caution will come out onto the speedway. Spring shootout coming up tonight. Out of turn four, they match the loud pedal. Here we go. Austin Horton, TJ Reed, three wide for the lead. But Travis Pennington's going to set it to the bottom and rock it away. Austin Horton's getting that capital car. He's peaking. He goes high, and that's going to cost him dearly off the corner as he falls back 3/10 of a lap. TJ Reed not wasting time to battle for the Rookie of the Year standings. Erupting for the second position. Travis Pennington leads the crowd out of four as he is rocking away from these guys so far. TJ Reed with the Tallahassee Terrell Tyler Crowder around and behind him. Austin Horton doing all he can to try to run down Pennington. But Pennington has got that Longhorn working good. Off into one and two, Horton made a big dive for him, but couldn't get to him. TJ Reed starting to get a little pressure from the Gator. But Austin Horton starting to run him down. Halfway in, halfway to go. The JYD out of Noonan, Georgia, putting on a fantastic run. Time running out. The 525 motor of Little Lightning trying to do something with these boys. Horton starting to drive a little bit over his head, and it's going to allow the young man to get away from him. The 20-year-old coming across, two to go this time by for Pennington. TJ Reed trying to get in the mix in that Capital race car. The leader of the DirtOnDirt.com cruiser with a champion Rookie of the Year standings. Down the back stretch into three and four. The white flag will fall for Travis Pennington. So Horton just cannot make up the ground on the exit. Coming out of turn four, Little Lightning, Travis Pennington will win Hoosier Heat Race number one. Second, Austin Horton, third, TJ Reed, third, fourth to Tyler Crowder, second to Austin Horton. So let's hear it up for Little Lightning, Travis Pennington. Pulling out the yellow backup car. They normally drives in limited in the Caswell Record Trucking Service machine. So Jason Fitzgerald, Zach Leonardi, the Zach Attack outside. They jump to the loud pedal. Here we go. So off into turns one and two they go. Jason Fitzgerald's going to lead a stampeding herd down the backstretch. Pearson Lee Williams with the 525 motor up under the hood. Eric Hickerson trying to get up under him. Zach Leonardi trying to work on him out of four. So Leonardi got him up under him. He'll clear Hickerson and go to third. Clint Smith trying to get up under Kane Hickman for the fifth position. He'll clear him. Out of four, Hickerson up under Leonardi as they battle for the third position. Side by side in a one and two, Hickerson's going to take him. Now here comes the Cat Daddy. He'll pass Leonardi. Out of four, Clint Smith now up to the fourth position. So Leonardi, the young 15-year-old, taking a throttling from the field as the veterans will move the 15-year-old halfway in, halfway to go for your race leader of Jason Fitzgerald. So Hickerson starting to run down Pearson Lee Williams for the second position. But Fitzgerald showing the way out of four to meet with the Georgia moonlight shining above it. So Hickerson knocking on the door of Pearson Lee Williams as they head down the backstretch. Two to go this time by for Jason Fitzgerald. Great battle for second as they down at the bottom poking at each other. Everybody, oh, Hickerson's gonna bobble. Here comes the Cat Daddy. He goes to third. So Fitzgerald's gonna see the white flag off into one and two. That Florida Gator chomping at the bit. He wins, he'll start third in the feature tonight. And he's gonna sauce him up out of four and he'll win Hoosier Heat Race number two. Second to Pearson Lee Williams. Third to the Cat Daddy. And fourth to Hickerson. Round out the top five is Zach Leonardi. So that completes heat race number two for our Southern All-Star Super Late Models. All right, lights are out. They go into turns three and four. Casey Roberts gonna rock it off this start. Here we go. So Roberts and Page square off in a one and two to fail to spin it out. Tristan Seeley trying to go to the bottom. He'll fall back to third. The field already single file. They come out of turn four. Jarrell Mosley gonna fight back with the 21 of Shane Tankersley. They go into one and two. Michael Page, he's on a bobble as the hot side is starting to go away. Tristan Seeley, the Moultrie Madman, third in the dirt on dirt. That come rookie of the year chase, trying to give chase to him. But Shane Tankersley in the 21, trying to get up under the 35T Capital race car. Casey Roberts showing out right now in this third heat race as he is checked away from Page. Carpenter trying to get up under Tankersley. They battle it out for the fourth position. Tankersley's gonna pull back away from him. Halfway in, halfway to go. Track still very grippy, as it's still got a lot of grip. And the brown gumbo down here at the Taj Mahal of Middle Georgia Cochran Motor Speedway. Good Lord. Mr. Casey Roberts, low 14 seconds, showing the way. Two to go this time by. And the bullhorns are out for heat race number three as the field is single file, catfishing in the pond. Swooping down to the bottom, getting all they can. White flag out for the Georgia Bandit. Start outside the pole tonight. Pimping harder than Snoop Dogg on four. Give it to Casey Roberts. Second to Michael Page. Third to Seeley. Fourth to Tankersley. Fifth to Carpenter. And sixth to Mosley. So not bad as Casey Roberts showed it to him. And let these boys know that he will be one of the ones to watch. Big Bad Bo Shirley, Omnit Lloyd, they are not gonna like that start. And that's gonna bring the caution out. Oh, a little contact right there with Ligon and Gar Dixon as those guys were still kind of racing. And out of four, they hop to the loud pedal. Good clean start this time. Here we go. So Bo Shirley closes the door as Ligon tried to get up under Brian Ligon. Excuse me, Omnit Lloyd is going to fall back to third, but he's going to try to answer back and get up there. Out of turn four, Big Bad Bo Shirley, a lead lap one. So Omnit Lloyd not wasting time going up to second as Brian Ligon will fall back to third, Gar Dixon in fourth, and Kelly Walker goes to fifth. Bo Shirley's got that Kepler car rolling out of four as he leads lap two. Ligon really hard on the throttle, went straight to the wall. He pulled it back in. Gar Dixon's gonna take the 525 motor and pull back in front of him. He goes to third. So Bo Shirley, former Southern All-Star winner at Talladega, Moulton Raceway, showing the way as he was only 1/1000th of a second off from Casey Roberts. Gar Dixon, three wide for a second, coming to the line. Ron Ligon, God almighty, a good battle for a second. Wheel to wheel, hub to hub, they go down the back. Ligon, he takes over second. And Omnit Lloyd to fall back to third. Gar Dixon trying to get up under him. They're side by side in the one and two. Guard Dixon will take the third spot as Ivan Lloyd goes back to fifth. Kelly Walker a passing. The Bullhorns are out. Two to go for your race leader of Bo Shirley. Ivan Lloyd off the pace in turns four. We stay green. White flag out for your race leader, Bo Shirley. Liking in second. Guard Dixon across the stripe. So Ivan Lloyd gets it back up in motion, didn't get the caution he wants. But pick it up, dirtondirt.com, heat race number four. Give it to Bo Shirley. Second to Brian Legan. Third to Guard Dixon. Fourth to Kelly Walker and Mark Page around out the fifth final position. So, picking up the fourth and final heat race. Let's hear it up for Gadsden, Alabama's own Big Bad Bo Shirley. Raise up, race fans, get up on your feet. Four wide salute. We're gonna do this right down here in Cochran, Georgia. Over there in turns number four. The juggernauts of the Sandlot, the baddest boys with the biggest toys, the premier series of the South. Here are your Southern All-Star Super Late Models. Wave your hands, flap your arms, shake a few babies. Don't shake a few babies. D-Facts will be on you. These guys are about to make some noise here at the Taj Mahal. I got my buddy down there doing a little turn up for them. And they're gonna get the one to go signal. We're about to turn them loose. 60 laps is the distance. A great surface, still got a lot of grip. Top, bottom, take a pick and hope it sticks. And out of turn four, Travis Pennant and Casey Roberts. They match that loud pedal every day we lit. Here we go. And they are lit, getting off into one and two. Travis Pennington. He's going to pull him down the back stretch. Jason Fitzgerald's going to get up under him. He's got a battle with Casey Roberts for second. Casey Roberts, what a power move on four. He goes to second. Austin Horton, the young man, trying to get into third. Casey Roberts, there's nothing up there. He's trying to fight with Roberts. Jason Fitzgerald to the bottom. Side by side on four. Give it to Roberts. Wow, look at Austin Horton. The JYD is up to third. Travis Pennington got the GM525 power up under the hood. He's gonna try to fight off these 800 plus open motor cars. So far, he's got a nice lead. As he holds the field, he is gonna hold that bottom. Casey Roberts trying to find the grip, caution out. Three and one and two. So caution coming out onto the speedway. And they come out of turn four, a little lightning. We got Powell up at three and four. Guard Dixon around, that'll bring the caution out. Take a big hit in the points. So here we go again, they crank it out of turn four, they mash that loud pedal, here we go. So they're gonna hammer away in a one and two. Casey Roberts gonna look under Pennington. Three wide back there for a position. Contact getting made on two. Look at Jason Fitzgerald, the juggernaut, high, wide, and handsome coming off the corner. And Austin Horton's gonna fall back to Pearson Lee Williams. The top is slick. He's gonna fall back to Page, but not for long. The JYD is in his backyard, and those teeth are sharp on that dog. So Pearson, caution out onto the speedway in three and four. Zach Leonardi and J.R. Mosley putting it in spin cycle. Out of turn four, every day we led. Here we go. And Michael Page, a big beeline move. Jason Fitzgerald to the top side. That boy just shot out of a cannon going into turns three and four. He's trying to get Michael Page for the third position. It's some up there. He's hustling that high side. So Austin Horton trying to get up in position and make something work. He'll clear Fitzgerald for the fourth. But man, that boy is carrying the juggernaut, playing it on the high side and getting at it. So the juggernaut on the top side, playing corn as he's got a rooster tail coming off turn two. He's gonna tuck it down to the bottom. TJ Reed's getting in the mix. He's up under him as Fitzgerald continues to fall back. And Travis Pennington, business is starting to pick up for him as the battle for the lead is about to get going. Travis Pennington, last Southern All-Star win, coming back in 2007 at the Alabama State Championship. 17 years old, also won at Rome, Georgia. Making history, TJ Reed's gonna slide high. He's gonna fall back. So Travis Pennington, Little Lightning, holding off one of the best in the Southeast out of Casey Roberts. Michael Page, Austin Horton runs fourth, third, and fourth. Fitzgerald fifth. Abner Lord trying to get around Bo Shirley for the final position, fifth position. Travis knows that Casey Roberts down there, and he's gone to the bottom. Kane Hickman is in the way. Lap cars. Oh my goodness. The battle for the lead. And Casey Roberts got more pimp in him than a Snoop Dogg video, and he's took the point. So the lap car costing Travis Pennington the lead. Now your race leader, Casey Roberts. He's gonna try to get that $7,500 payday tonight. Travis Pennington, lights are out. They put it down to the firewall. Here we go. What a restart for Michael Page. So Michael Page is gonna set it in there with the Club 29 Detroit Baird entry. Him and Casey Roberts side by side in the three and four. Down to the bottom. Roberts gonna try to hold him. Give it to Roberts for a second. So Michael Page, high side hustling. What a run down the backstretch. He'll tuck it in between Roberts and Horton and battle all four. So everybody scrambling and fighting to get to the bottom of the speedway. Casey Roberts, just not as strong as Pennington in the center. And around goes TJ Reed. He gets it back straight and gets it going. Man, that boy can drive. What a wheel man on TJ Reed, and the rest of the guys averting the danger. We say green flag racing. So Travis Pennington has really got that Longhorn car working to his advantage. Showing the way out of four. Little Lightning putting his foot down on him as they come to the stripe. So TJ Reed's gonna take it over the outside wall and call it a day. So Pennington just a wonderful race car right now working for him. Michael Page, Austin Horton running third and fourth, close to each other, both Shirley and Fell trying to hold on Fitzgerald, and I'm the Lord of Pair Floridians. So lap traffic gonna come back into play as Brian Legan is sitting on the list for Pennington. Man, oh man, the horsepower these guys are putting down on this speedway when they drive it off into one and two. You know these boys mean business. So Legan's gonna get out the way for Pennington to put him a lap down. Casey Robertson second, trying to run him back down. Now Hickerson's gonna go a lap down as they go into three and four. So the field is spanned out and is starting to get racy and racers. The top line is starting to come back in. Pennington sees Crowder and he's gonna put him a lap down. Definitely the GM Performance 525 under the hood. This will be a mighty big upset as it could become the first time in Southern All-Star history the power plant will win an open competition race amongst the 34 years of the series. So Mosley in front of Pennington. He's holding the bottom. Pennington's gonna try. Casey Roberts to the outside. All four, they're gonna battle for the lead. So Roberts back to the high side. He's gonna get the run. Down the backstretch. The Georgia Bandit. He's got the crowd on their feet. What a race for the lead. So Roberts back to the outside. Cadillac leaning side by side. Who is the number one hustler? The number one stunner, all four, what a race. J.R. Mosley has got your leader in the fit. Roberts rocking it on two. Pennington's gonna bobble. Roberts trying for all he's got up top, but he just cannot make up the ground. And J.R. Mosley gets out of the way. Roberts goes to the bottom, kills the momentum, and is gonna allow Pennington to get about a three-car length lead. All four, he's dealing with Shane Tankersley, former Southern All-Star champ. Oh, and Pennington's got a bobble. Michael Page starting to slide into the mix as making his presence known. So Carpenter is gonna get in front of your race leader as he's bouncing through the ruts. He knows he's gotta keep the bottom closed. Carpenter really shut the door. The top three's together. A race on four, what a showdown. So Carpenter is gonna allow your race leader by. Roberts not holding up, not drawing back the punches. Look at Michael Page trying to take advantage. And he falls back to third. Horton's gonna get in the mix. So the top four don't work their way in. Oh, Pennington, the bobble on four. The Georgia Bandit pimping on him. Gonna take the point. 22 laps left. We're past halfway. All four, Casey Roberts, the new leader, as Michael Page gets his eyes set on Pennington. So Tankersley is now in the way of Roberts. Roberts, the veteran, tucks it in. All four rockets away as Pennington trying to close back up the gap. 20 laps to go. 7,500 on the line. Page goes high. 19 to go this time by. Casey Roberts, back mirror's getting full of the 0-1 of Travis Pennington. But not for long, the big motor's gonna snatch him off the corners. And J.R. Mosley's gonna call it a day. Track, really good. Austin Horton running forward for a career high finish with the Southern All-Stars here tonight. So as time's starting to run out, 17 in, make it 16 this time by. Bo Shirley staying in the mix as he's fifth right now. That'll give him a nice cushion over Clint Smith. Ivan Lloyd off the pace in turns four. Will we see a caution? And the caution will fly here on the front stretch for Ivan Lloyd with 15 laps to go. And here we go. Out of turn four, in the words of MC Hammer, it's hammer time. So Bo Shirley trying to get up into the mix. Michael Page to the top side. He's going to get the momentum. He's going to go around Travis Pennington. Side by side in the turns three and four. Look at that high side momentum. So Page chasing that top side, getting after him. He's going to tuck it back to the bottom to no avail. And out of three and four, Casey Roberts will hold the point with 13 to go. So the field trying to span it out right. Tristan Seeley done worked his way up to six. Fitzgerald's now up to fifth. 12 to go this time by. So out of turn four, Casey Roberts got the race under control. He goes off into one and two, he's gonna hit those bumps nicer than those rear end on Beyonce. Oh man, what a boy showing it to him tonight. Give it to him, Casey. Second, Travis Pennant. Been stunting on him for the most part of this race. A lap car will cost him. Third, Michael Page. Fourth, Austin Horton with a career run with the Southern All-Stars. Fifth, Fitzgerald. Sixth, Seeley. Seventh, Bo Shirley. Eighth, the 21 of Tankersley. Ninth, Carpenter, and 10th of Hickerson. Eight laps left in this one. Who's got the right flavor to take it home? Here in Cocker. Six to go this time by. Make that seven to go this time by. We're clicking them off, six to go this time by. Five to go, four. Casey Roberts on four. Casey Roberts dipping down into the ooey-gooey catfish pond, getting all the grip that he can handle. And he's still rocking it off four. Four to go this time by. Flawless race. Casey Roberts gonna win. Trying to go three out of four with the Southern All-Stars this season so far. Chris Martin watching those pockets grow up as these laps winding down. Oh man, but thank the Martin family for having us down here at the Taj Mahal of Middle Georgia Cochran Motor Speedway. Time running out. Who's got something for Roberts? As he's up to a straightaway length lead. He comes out of four. The Bullhorns are out, two to go for the Georgia Bandit. With not much time left in Hourglass, Casey Roberts stunting on him. He brings it in out of turn four to the high side, working on Carpenter. The white rag will fall. He goes off into one and two. He's about to be $7,500 richer. Chasing that money harder than an athlete's girlfriend. Shake the haters off your body. Ooh, give it a Roberts tonight. Second, Pennington. Third, Michael Page. Fourth, Austin Horton. And fifth to Jason Fitzgerald. Casey Roberts
getting close. Michael Page finishing third. Travis Pennington second. Austin Horn career high. Southern All-Star finishing fourth. All right, here's your race winner, the Georgia Bandit, Casey Roberts.
Oh, it ain't gonna be all.
All right, there, Casey. We didn't know which way you were gonna go. You were gonna go to Virginia, or you gonna go to Batesville, or you wanna come down here. You seem like you chose right, man. Was the gamble paid off tonight?
Yeah, absolutely. We had a good car there. I got into Travis there. He kind of got in a lap car, and he kind of opened the hole there, and I tried to fill it there. But it's like everybody running for the bottom, and, you know, I filled the hole, and he come down a little, and we got together. It's just one of them deals. But had a great car. I just like to dedicate this to my Little League coach, Hollis Gasly. He passed away last night. And, you know, guys like that makes an impact on your life, like your kindergarten teacher or whatever. You know, you never forget people like that. But I just like to dedicate this win to him. He taught me a lot there. He's a good, great guy. But just got to thank M&S Concrete. Michael's here with us tonight. Just got to thank him. And Cushman Paint and Body, I hate my corners couldn't be here. But Penske Racing Shocks, they've done awesome. And Longhorn Chassis, C&H Paving, Bad Boy Off-Road, just Schaefer Racing Oil, VP Race Fuel, Hoosier Racing Tire, everybody that helps out to make this possible. And just thank Stinky and Kason and the whole gang there, Daniel and all of them, and my son and wife there for helping out and always being there. And just had a good car here, you know, and everything worked out for us. Also, thank the fans for coming out and coming supporting the racetrack. And just thank the good Lord for all he does, and hopefully have us a safe trip home.
Definitely. And at one time, you and Travis, y'all were battling out for the lead. Y'all had to deal with that lap car on multiple occasions. It cost the lead. It gave it back to you. So it was kind of playing Indian giver. What was going on with that, brother?
Yeah, it's, this place is, you know, around the bottom there. When you go around the top, it's so far out there. I thought I might could try it up there, but, man, they just, you know, they wasn't much up there. And he kind of come back on us there and had a great car. Congratulations to him. He done an awesome job. Me and Jack's old buddies, and he's an awesome driver. And Travis is a heck of a wheel man there, too.
Well, definitely. Congratulations. You're now 3 out of 4 of the Southern All-Stars. You might need to tell Jimmy Cushman to stay home, brother.
Yeah, I don't know about that.
Definitely. We're down here with our second place man tonight. All right, that Travis, you led close to half of this race. You were definitely flawless a lot, especially off the corners of turn 2 and turn 4. Did you know you had that good of a car tonight?
Yeah, we had a really good car. It was hard getting through lap traffic, and I got under the 21, I think Shane Tankersley or something. And I was under him, and he just come across my nose, and I got into the inside wall, and Casey got by me. But, you know, Casey's a heck of a wheel man, so to run second to him, that ain't bad.
Definitely. This is your first Southern All-Star appearance in a while now, man, and we know you're growing up on the ladder as you're starting to work your way more into the racing career. We're going to see you at a lot more of these bigger events like these, brother.
We might come to a few. All we got right now is this 525 motor, but you know, you never know. We might get us a big motor and start running some.
Now, definitely, when you seen the lap cars, not only that, was that outside just a little bit too sketchy for you to really try it out, brother, or just got to hold that bottom?
Yeah, the track was really just right in the bottom, as close as you could get to the wall. I know there was nothing on the outside. You know, I'd be better off riding behind the lap car than to get out there. But, you know, we had a good car tonight. I want to thank K&L Rumley Enterprises, JRI Shocks, Philip Duffy, U.S. Duffy, Melcher Hall, and Storette Trucking, Kenny Lamb Racing Engines.
Definitely. Congratulations. Good run, brother. And we might see a third place. We'll see our third generation coming up here soon, hanging with you there. Let's hear that for Little Lightning, Travis Pennington. All right, there, Michael. You just got this Club 29 race car. You decided to debut it against a stacked field, brother. How did you like this car on this track that you ain't very familiar with right now?
It was pretty good. Heat race was way too tight. Couldn't hardly get it turned for nothing. So it put us back a little bit. And in long runs, we were pretty good in the race. It's just, and they weren't going to move off the bottom. I was trying the top. Nobody helped roll it in. It's 3 inches of fluff up there, and I gave it a shot, but it just wasn't good enough.
Definitely. I know you was really digging hard a couple times on the top side. You'll go back. You'll come forward. You'll go back. You're going forward. Were you just playing tug of war, or you just trying to get the fans a show?
I don't like running third or second. So, you know, we try to win the race. We all do.
Definitely, brother. Anybody you want to thank for this great third place tonight?
Troy Baird for coming in and helping us. All my help. TNT Trucking, CNS All Electric, Elite Concrete. Just all my help. Appreciate it.
Definitely. Let's hear it again for Michael Page. Good job, brother.